In this video, we'll go over the Philips Lumify settings menu, where you will learn how to set and adjust important functions like the loop duration and changing the cardiac image orientation. To access the Lumify app settings, open the menu and tap Settings at the bottom. We're going to go through this from top to bottom. The very top setting allows you to choose the duration of the ultrasound loops that you want to save. You can set the length to be anything from 1 to 10 seconds. The power saving setting lowers the frame rates when the system is not scanning. This saves power and extends battery life, and is a helpful tip if you want to extend the battery life of your tablet. The cardiac image orientation setting allows you to flip the orientation marker on the ultrasound image. By default, Lumify adopts the echocardiologist convention of image orientation. Unchecking this box reverses this orientation to the format some POC users prefer. The control orientation setting allows you to orient the system controls based on which hand you use to hold the transducer. The next option, power control, allows you to choose whether or not to have the transmit power control available in the control panel. If you uncheck the box, you will not have the power control available in the main ultrasound control panel while you are scanning. Next is the thermal index display. You can choose which of the three thermal indices, soft tissue, bone, or cranial, to display on the imaging screen. Each clinical preset defaults to the most commonly correct setting, but if you wish to override this, we allow it in this control. If you hit the barcode settings option in the barcode scanner section, you will be able to take a look at your existing barcode settings and to add new barcodes to your system. With Lumify, your device's camera is your barcode scanner, and it's easy to train Lumify to recognize your institution's barcodes. Simply tap Add New and then drag and drop to arrange the entries into the correct fields. In the unlikely event that patient database gets corrupted for some reason, the patient database section is where you can repair or reset it. If you encounter a database problem and these steps don't take care of it, don't hesitate to get in touch with our Lumify service rep. The system allows you to send the system logs to Philips if there's a problem with your system. You also have the option to automatically send those logs by checking the box you see here. The Lumify system keeps a record of when patient data has been accessed. You can view that record in the Audit Log section. Tapping on one of the dates listed allows you to see more information about what took place on that day. The Customer Information section is where you have the option to edit or erase the information you provide when you register your transducer. The next section is where you have the option to adjust your Lumify React's camera, call, and account settings. React's is the technology that drives Lumify tele-ultrasound capabilities, giving you the ability to connect in real time when and where health professionals want it, to simultaneously stream your camera, voice, and ultrasound to enhance remote collaboration. The first setting deals with whether or not you want to have your camera activated and visible to the remote user as soon as the call is placed. If you want your camera to be active as soon as the call is placed, choose Yes. If not, choose No. If you want either the front or back-facing camera by default, you can choose one or the other. Call settings gives you the option to choose whether or not you want to start the call with the device's microphone muted, or if you want it to be active when you first place the call. Many users will like to have the microphone muted at first, just so they have the option to control what their remote users hear before they are ready to talk. You also have the option, yes or no, to automatically share the ultrasound stream when you start the call. You have the option in the Account and Login section, yes or no, to automatically log into your React's account as soon as you open Lumify. This essentially allows you to bypass the React's login screen each time you want to use the feature. And, of course, you can clear any saved React's username or password in that section as well. The Wi-Fi settings section provides a shortcut to the device Wi-Fi settings page, in case you're unfamiliar with the type of device that you have the Lumify app installed on. The next section allows you to run a test on the Lumify transducer to check if it is working properly. If you suspect something is not as it should be, please feel free to reach out to your Philips service representative. The last section, where it says Registered Transducers, will show a list of all the transducers that are registered with your tablet. This section is for people who have multiple transducers, or who might be subscribed to one or multiple transducers and they want to quickly determine info about their transducers or the status of their transducer registration. Tapping on one of the transducers in the table will bring up more information about the transducer: serial number, model number, material number, how many days you have left to renew your transducer registration. Registration renewal is only applicable for Lumify subscribers, and it also shows the transducer's registration status. Keep in mind that this section is automatically updated when you connect your device to the internet.
Now that you are familiar with what is included in the Lumify settings menu, you know where to go to ensure you are making the most of your Lumify ultrasound system.